In this video, we're looking at an inelastic collision between two identical blocks. One of them is initially stationary, but this collision is complicated by the fact that we have a rough surface and we have a kinetic friction coefficient given to us. Throughout the entire process, that's going to be 0.15. So in our initial state, one of the blocks is moving with a given initial velocity of 3 meters per second, and it slides through 1 meter before the impact occurs, and during that 1 meter, it's slowing down. So in part A, we have to figure out what's the speed just before the impact. In part B, we're going to apply conservation of momentum to figure out the speed of the stuck together blocks after the impact. And then in part C, after those blocks are stuck together, they're going to slow down as friction continues to work on them. And eventually they're going to come to a stop. And we're trying to figure out how far do they slide after they're stuck together. So to get started with part A, we want the speed of that initially moving block after it slides 1 meter. We've got to get the acceleration of it to get that done. That means we need to figure out the size of the friction force on it. So we're going to pop in all the vectors for a force analysis. And there are 3 forces acting on this block. Of course, we have gravity pulling straight down with a magnitude of mg. Since m is 1 and we're using 9.8 as an approximation for g, that's 9.8 newtons pointing down. Then we have a normal force pushing up. And because there are no other forces acting vertically in this problem, the normal force must exactly balance the force of gravity pointing down, so that's 9.8 newtons. And then pointing to the left, we have the friction force. I'll call that Fk. That's given by the coefficient of kinetic friction, mu k, multiplied by the normal force, little n. Multiplying 0.15 times 9.8, we get a kinetic friction force of 1.47 newtons. Now that we have the horizontal force acting on this block, we can apply Newton's second law to figure out the magnitude of the acceleration. I'm going to write Newton's second law as A equals F over M, and we just plug in our force of 1.47 newtons, plug in our mass of 1 kilogram, dividing by 1 is easy enough, and I end up with a magnitude for my acceleration of 1.47 meters per second squared. Now, when we take this acceleration and plug it into a kinematics equation, you have to remember to put a minus sign on it because we're going to use a coordinate system where rightward means positive and leftward means negative. So this is negative 1.47 when we plug it in. So we want the speed of this block after it slides for 1 meter. And there's a kinematics equation that gets this done in one step. It's the time-independent equation. V squared is equal to V naught squared plus 2a times the quantity x minus x naught. X naught is our initial position, which we're going to call 0. And to find the final speed, I just have to plug everything in on the right-hand side and take the square root. So v naught squared, that's 3 squared. Now our acceleration is going to take a minus sign again because it points to the left. So I have minus 2 times 1.47. And then our sliding distance is 1 meter. So it's kind of optional to even show that since multiplying by 1 doesn't change anything. When we run the numbers on this and round to 3 significant digits, we get 2.46 meters per second just before the collision occurs. Now in part B, we want the speed of the blocks just after the collision occurs. So we're just looking at this instant in time where an inelastic collision occurs, meaning the blocks get stuck together. There is no motion during that instant for friction to do any work, so we don't have to think about that. We're just doing pure momentum conservation here. So P initial is equal to P final for that instantaneous collision. In our initial momentum just before the collision occurs, that requires the speed we computed in part A. The leftmost block was moving at 2.46 meters per second. So my initial momentum will be the mass of that block times its speed coming into the collision, 2.46 meters per second. My final momentum, now I have 2 blocks stuck together, both moving for a total of 2 kilograms, and I have an unknown final velocity. So to solve for VF, well, the kilograms cancel there, and we're just dividing both sides by 2, and we get that the final velocity that's just after the impact occurs is 1.23 meters per second. Finally, in part C, we want to get the sliding distance for these stuck together blocks after the collision occurs, and this is basically just the reverse of what happened in part A. We know the initial velocity of the stuck together blocks is going to be 1.23 meters per second. We know the final velocity of the stuck together blocks is 0 because we're trying to figure out how far they slide before they stop. Well, at the end of the process, V is equal to 0. And the acceleration of these blocks as they slide to a stop is actually going to be equal to the value that we computed in part A. It might not be obvious at first why this is true, so we'll go ahead and analyze it as a 2 kilogram mass and show that it's true. So just to be thorough here, here's a 2 kilogram mass. That's the stuck together blocks. And then the force analysis is familiar. We've got gravity pulling down on this mass. With a magnitude of mg, this time m is 2, so our weight is 2 times 9.8, or 19.6 newtons. Again, no forces are interfering vertically, so our normal force is equal to the weight, 19.6 newtons. And our friction force, again, is the coefficient of kinetic friction multiplying the normal force, which is now twice as much as it was before. So our friction force has doubled simply because our mass has doubled. It's now 2.94 newtons. But notice from Newton's second law, A equals F over M. If I double the force on a mass and I also double the mass, the factors of two are going to cancel out and my acceleration is going to be the same. So just to see that this works, my friction force is 2.94 newtons. My mass is now 2 kilograms, and I arrive at the same number for the acceleration, 1.47 meters per second squared. And again, that counts as negative once we get it into a kinematics equation. So we're going to apply the time-independent kinematics equation again. V squared equals V naught squared plus 2a times x minus x naught. We're going to take our initial position as zero just after the impact occurs. Our final speed is also zero because these blocks are sliding until they come to rest. And what we're after here is that little x. And we can solve for that very quickly by subtracting V naught squared from both sides and dividing by 2a. So our sliding distance is going to be a negative V naught squared divided by twice the acceleration. And the initial speed, well, that's the speed after the collision occurs. That's 1.23, and I need to square that. And remember that A takes a minus sign because it points to the left. And this is good because the minus signs cancel and I get a positive value for X. In other words, the blocks end up to the right of where they began. And our sliding distance to three significant figures is 0.515 meters. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.